falling star. Can you make a wish? Ooh, just remember luck is no such thing. One man succeeds while another man fails. Why is it then you ask the stars up above?
Coming to you live from Harlem, New York City, you're watching Astrology Numerology Now. It's Thursday, October 28, 2021. I'm your host. You already know. This is Z Starman, Zaki Z Starman, professional astrologer, numerologist, where every week we give you the latest astrology news and information. This show has been on the air since 2014, and currently it is New York City's longest running show on astrology and numerology. The purpose of the show is to promote astrology, numerology awareness. It's not about being, it's not about your religion. You could be Catholic, Baptist, Jewish, Muslim. You could be LGBTQ. It doesn't matter. We're all under the influence of astrology and numerology. And everyone should have an astrologer. People have psychiatrists and lawyers and doctors and hairdressers and barbers and beauticians and even mechanics for their car. Understand, astrology is about understand how the planets are moving and spinning and turning in your life. So get an astrologer if you want to know more about yourself from an astrology point of view. We're going to talk about it, or you can give me a call later on after the show to get your astrology and numerology charts done. Now, we're approaching November 2021, the year is almost coming to a close. We got about two more months of 2021 left, and it's been a hell of a year, from the insurrection at the Capitol to fires and floods and all kind of climate changes to computers being hacked. So this has been one hell of a year, to say the least. But on today's show, we're going to get you ready for November and give you November 2021 astrology and numerology highlights. Now, before I begin the show, I just want to give a shout out and say congratulations to Eric Adams. Eric Adams will be the next mayor of New York City. Eric Adams, his birthday is September 1st, 1960, and he has the moon in Capricorn, and he has a number 8 life path number. The 8 life path number is about power and business. Know what your life path number is. But I just want to say congratulations to Eric. I grew up with Eric Adams, and my mother used to babysit Eric Adams, the next mayor of New York City. And he's always been a fine guy, his mother and his family and his brothers and sisters. And I think he'll be one of the best mayors that New York City has ever seen. Again, he's a Virgo, he's a hard worker. And his birthday, again, is September 1st, 1960. He's a Virgo with the moon in Capricorn. So congratulations to Eric Adams being elected mayor of New York City. Now, there are a lot of elections and things going on in the month of November, but we got to get out this information. I want everyone within the sound of my voice and within their vision to stay right where it is so we can understand what's going on. I'm about to talk about some November 2021 astrology and numerology highlights. Now, to begin that, I want to say happy birthday to all the Scorpio people, because it's Scorpio season. So we're going to say happy birthday to the Scorpios and those with Scorpio rising. This is the start of your astrological new year. Scorpio season began on October 23rd and it ends on November 21st at 9:33 p.m. Eastern time. Some people will say, wait a minute, Starman, usually that's November 22nd, but the start and end times of every sign change from year to year. So this is a powerful time for all the Scorpio people and other water signs. Water signs are in power also. So water signs like Cancer and also Pisces. This is the season for all the water signs to make something happen and to make things happen in your lifetime. So happy birthday to all the Scorpios, to all the sexy, beautiful Scorpio women, and to the handsome, strong Scorpio men. Now, Scorpio, a lot of people think that Scorpio is about sex, sex, sex all the time. I know some Scorpios who are nuns. They're nuns, they're not into sex. They're just inner transformation. Their ruling planet is Pluto. If you're a Scorpio, your ruling planet is Pluto. And Pluto is always about birth. Pluto is about transformation. So a lot of people or a lot of Scorpios, those with Scorpio rising sign, they're transformative people. Up next, from a numerology point of view, since the name of the show is astrology numerology. Now, the month of November 2021 is a number 7 universal month. If you're just watching the show for the very first time, numerology is the study of numbers. And every number from 1 to 9 has a distinct characteristic to it. And we have master numbers like 11, 22, and 33. Now, the number 7 is about mysticism, it's about spirituality, it's about being alone and going deep within oneself. A lot of number 7 people don't like a lot of company. They're their own best companies. But one of the energies or the purposes of a number 7 universal month, and this is where everybody, no matter what sign you are, is to dig deep inside of yourself and finding the spiritual vehicles that you need to sort of kind of, especially in the Northern Hemisphere, is to get you through the winter. Prayer, meditation, new age things like yoga, I Ching, whatever your new age value is, get into that, lock into that in a number 7 universal month. It's about spirituality and vibrating on a higher frequency in a number 7 universal month. Up next, this is, if you're just tuning in, this is Z Starman, Zaki Z Starman, with the latest astrology numerology information, and you're watching Astrology Numerology Now. Now, we have a new moon on November 4th. We have a new moon in the sign of Scorpio. New moons are about new things. And this first week of Scorpio, or the first week of November, is going to be a testing week for all of us, because we got a lot of planets that are moving into the sign of Scorpio. If you're just watching, this is November 2021 astrology numerology highlight. So we're in Scorpio season for the start of November, but we have this new moon coming on November 4th, 2021. Watch out for all the new things when it comes to birth, death, and transformation. On a new moon is the best time to implement new ideals into your life. So we got that new moon in the sign of Scorpio on November 4th at 5:14 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. So watch out for the new moon in Scorpio. And again, this is Scorpio season. So we have other planets that are shifting into the sign of Scorpio. We all have Scorpio somewhere in our chart, no matter where and where you were born. And if you want to know more about the Scorpio planets, give me a call later on in the show. I'm going to put up the number. Here's the number, 917-473-2211. 917-473-2211. I'm on all the social media platforms. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram as ZStarman, or you can visit our show page, Astrology Numerology Now on Facebook. Now, as I've said earlier, we have a lot of activity going on in the sign of Scorpio. In addition to the new moon in Scorpio, we have Mars. Mars will be in the sign of Scorpio from October 30th to December 13th. Now, Pluto is the ruler of Scorpio. Now, before Pluto was discovered, Mars used to be the co-ruler of or co-ruled Scorpio and Aries. So sort of kind of, I'm an old school astrologer also. So Mars is in the sign of Scorpio. It's coming back home. And Mars is about destruction, fighting, transformation. I just want to tell everybody during this Scorpio season is to think before you speak, is to not to get in fights, arguments, or disagreements during Scorpio season. A lot of people will die. There's going to be a lot of deaths and transformations over stupid stuff. I think we will see with this Mars and Scorpio some mass shootings somewhere on the planet. So, you know, watch your back with Mars and Scorpio. All my Scorpio people and those with Scorpio rising sign, control your temper. Even if you have the moon in Scorpio, Mercury in Scorpio, Venus in Scorpio. And this goes out to the other fixed signs also. The fixed signs, like Scorpio, are in the middle of the seasons. Leo is in the middle of summer. Scorpio is in the middle of the fall. Aquarius is in the middle of winter. And Taurus is in the middle of the spring. So it's going to be a lot of pressure on the fixed signs during Scorpio season, because you got oppositions. Taurus is opposite, which is challenging Scorpio. A lot of Taurus people, get your act together during this time. A lot of Leo people, think about maybe you want to make some changes in your family. Aquarius people, think about changes in your career with all these planets in the sign of Scorpio. So there's a lot going on. And Scorpio people, or Scorpio rising sign, think about the changes that you have to make with yourself, especially with all these planets in the sign of Scorpio. Now, it's going to help out some water sign people. The water sign people are Pisces and Cancer, or moon child, as I like to say. So there's a lot going on in the sign of Scorpio. This is Z Starman, professional astrologer, numerologist. And again, we're reviewing the November 2021 astrology, numerology highlights. We're sort of kind of coming down to the end of the year. We're really now starting to begin the holiday season. You know, we have Thanksgiving coming up at the end of November. But we're at the first couple of weeks of November here on Astrology Numerology Now. Now, up next, what else do we have in Scorpio? Oh, we have some aspects that I want everybody to pay attention to. But before those aspects, I'm just looking at my notes here. And I just want to give this to Capricorn people. Venus is in the sign of Capricorn. See, that first week of November, Venus will be moving into the sign of Capricorn. And Venus will be in Capricorn for the next 4 months. Venus is going to be in Capricorn for the next 4 months. And Venus is going to be in Capricorn from November 5th to March 6th. But one thing that we have to expect, why is it going to be in Capricorn? Because we got a Venus retrograde coming up. We got a Venus retrograde coming up from December 19th. 2021 to January 29th, 2022. So if there are any Capricorns, you got Capricorn rising or moon in Capricorn, expect changes in your financial situation with the moon or with Venus moving into the sign of Capricorn. This is going to be challenging with this Venus in Capricorn. It's going to be challenging for Libras, Aries, and Cancer people. during this period for the next 4 months. So with Venus being in Capricorn, it gives all of us an opportunity to straighten out our finances and to sort of kind of search where finances are hidden. Now is a great time to ask people for the money they owe you or to invest in yourself. But Venus is going to be in Capricorn. A lot of Capricorn people look for love to come your way, look for financial opportunities to come your way with Venus being in the sign of Capricorn. Now, I'd like to talk about some of the aspects that are coming up. And aspects, what are aspects? The seasoned astrologers know what aspects are, but if you're a lay person just listening to the show, aspects are the relationships planet or the geometric relationships that planets have with each other. And one major aspect that we have coming up, again, that first week of November, watch out for that first week of November. We have the sun opposing Uranus on November 4th. See, November 4th is a lot. The 4th and the 5th, there's going to be a lot of stuff going on. So we have Uranus opposing or sun opposing Uranus. The sun is in Scorpio, Uranus in Taurus. So there's a lot of back and forth struggles and physical energies for Taurus and Scorpio people, but it also gives you chance to connect and lock in and sort of kind of regenerate yourself. Uranus is the planet of transformation. Well, sudden changes. You look at Uranus, Uranus is the only planet that moves on its side around the zodiac. It's 42 years of light on Uranus and 42 years of darkness on Uranus. But this is a powerful aspect. Watch out for changes in the financial market. That whole first week of November with your sun opposing Uranus on November 4th. Another aspect we got going on, and Scorpio people, please listen to me when I tell you about these aspects. And one aspect that we have coming up is Mercury, the planet of thought and communication, with Mars in the sign of Scorpio. So Mercury's in Scorpio, Mars is in Scorpio, the sun is in Scorpio, we got this new moon in the sign of Scorpio. But on November 10th, we have Mercury conjunct Mars. See that first week of November. Mercury is about thoughts, communication, and information, and Mars is about fighting, changing energy, how you use your energy. No day other than what it is in the remainder of the year, watch out how you talk to people, watch out how you say things to people, watch out how you communicate with people. A lot of communication venues will be tested and sort of kind of wiped out on November 4th. Watch what happens to Facebook. Watch what happens to Facebook and all the other internet portals that we got going on, and especially with Mars and Mercury in the sign of Scorpio during November 10th. November 10th, Mars and Mercury are conjunct, meaning they're next to each other. They're right next to each other or in alignment with each other on November 10th. So watch out for that day. Especially all my fixed signs. This is the fixed signs, Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, and Aquarius. Be careful at that day. Then we have Mars opposing. See this Mars and Scorpio energy. Mars is going to be opposing Uranus on November 17th. See, the purpose of astrology is to get you ready. Just like the weatherman gives you the forecast, they give you the 5-day forecast or 1-week forecast. Astrology is about giving you the forecast of how the planets are moving, spinning, and turning so you can prepare yourself. Just like in a hurricane or storm, the weather channel and the weather services give out, and they tell you, okay, here's a tornado is coming, a hurricane is coming, a tsunami is coming, and people get a chance to board up their shops, their homes, their businesses. with astrology, it's sort of kind of the same thing. If you know an aspect is coming, like we have the Mercury conjunct Mars, or your Mars opposing Uranus, which will occur on November 17th, we have to get ready for all kinds of trouble and all kinds of not so nice things happening with Mars opposing Uranus. Wars will break out unexpectedly. See, Uranus is about the unexpected. Don't let the wars and fights break out in your personal life during this period. While we are in Scorpio season, especially on November 10th, with Mercury conjunct Mars, or being next to Mars, or Mars opposite Uranus or Uranus. Be careful of those days. I can't stress these days enough from an astrology point of view, with the oppositions and all the activity that's happening in the sign of Scorpio. Scorpio, your life is getting ready to change. Or if you have Scorpio rising. And again, as I said earlier, Scorpio is in everybody's chart. There's more to you than just being a Leo or a Pisces or Sagittarius or Aquarius. All the planets we have to deal with are in our astrology charts. If you want to know your astrology chart, if you want to know what your sun, moon, and rising signs are, give me a call after the show. The number again is 917-473-2211, 917-473-2211. And you can find me on all the social media platforms. I'm on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram as Z Starman. And also you can find the show, Astrology Numerology Now show page, where we have previous shows, all kinds of astrology news and information on Facebook. Just go to Facebook and look for Astrology Numerology Now. I'm your host, Z Starman. Now, we have one more major event in November that everyone should be aware of. And that is, we're going to have a lunar eclipse on November, looking at my notes, we're going to have a partial lunar eclipse on November the 19th, early in the morning here in New York City. It begins about 1 o'clock in the morning, excuse me, but we will not see the total eclipse or the partial eclipse until about 4 o'clock in the morning. So if you want to be up and see a lunar eclipse, and a lunar eclipse is when the Earth comes between the sun and the moon. So we're going to having this lunar eclipse. Again, the Earth is going to be blocking out the light of the moon. It's not a total eclipse, but the moon will be blocked out or at least I would say a good 95% of it will be blocked out. And if you're up around 2 o'clock or 4 o'clock in the morning, you can visually see that. So this is a lunar eclipse, again, happening on November 19th around about 1 o'clock in the morning, and it's happening for hours. Excuse me. And lunar eclipses are about the ultimate change and the ultimate transformation. The sun is in the sign of Scorpio, the moon is in Taurus, and the Earth is in the sign of Taurus. And then we had a lot of planets come out of retrograde during the month of October. Jupiter was retrograde, Mercury was retrograde, Saturn was retrograde, Pluto was retrograde, meaning the energies of the planets were moving in reverse. But this moon this lunar eclipse in the sign of Taurus on November 19th, the wee hours of the morning as we approach sunrise, It's going to turn the world around. It's going to transform everybody. We have to be ready for this. But one thing I like to say during a lunar eclipse, I remember growing up as a child. And my parents are from the South, and we had to turn off the TV, we had to turn off the radio whenever there was a severe thunderstorm or lightning storm. And my mother used to say, be quiet, God is talking. Right through here with this lunar eclipse, partial lunar eclipse, 95% of the moon will be covered. God and the universe is trying to send us earthlings messages. During this lunar eclipse, do not get out of control. Do not fight. Turn off the TV, turn off your radio, turn off your Netflix and Hulu, and just meditate and vibrate and tune in to the transformative energy that's on the horizon for us. This is a very, very important part of the year for us with this lunar eclipse on November the 19th, a couple of days before Thanksgiving. The world is about to change, but it's about changing yourself during this lunar eclipse on November 19th. That's about all the time we have for astrology numerology. Now, I want to thank my lovely producer and director, Dietra Kelsey, for facilitating the show, and you, the viewers, for watching. Now, if you'd like, you can leave a comment on our Instagram page or our YouTube page. You can leave a comment in the comment section and tell us how you like the show. I'm your host, Z Starman, wishing you peace, love, light, namaste.
And it's a mind who controls your very soul. Ask them why the whistle sound and practical. Yet Gemini, so inconsistent. Ooh, let me tell you a secret I know. Known the world over, your life is controlled by the stars. Ooh, the planet of life.